Hello students, welcome to the online lecture series of accounting and finance management. This is your sixth lecture of this series, and in this lecture we will try to understand modern approach of accounting. So what is modern approach of accounting? We shall go through and try to understand it about modern approach of accounting. So in the previous lecture we have discussed about traditional approach of accounting. So what were traditional approach of accounting? There were three accounts we have studied: personal, nominal and real. And what were the rules of it? The rules said debit the receiver and credit the giver. Second one was debit what comes in, credit what goes out, debit all the expenses and losses, credit all the income and gains. So that was your traditional approach which we have studied in previous lecture. Today we shall go through with the modern approach of accounting. All right, so as before dig into it, we shall go through with the questions. What are the questions which has been asked in the previous examination? What is modern approach of accounting? Define the following rules. What is the rule of expense? What is the rule of liability? What is the rule of revenue? So we shall cover each and every topic in this lecture. So let's get started. Or you can go with the modern rules of accounting, a modern approach of accounting. In modern approach, we actually classify our accounting in five major accounts, which is capital, assets, liability, expense, income, of course. Okay, so let's dig into it. Let's understand all of this. Okay. Remember, when the first class we were discussing it, I told you that there is assets and there is liability. Okay, before digging deep, we shall understand what is assets and liability. We have already covered assets. Now I will cover the liabilities. So what is liability? A liability is something a person or company owes, usually sum of money, of course. Suppose you have, Ram has given 100. Suppose Ram borrowed 100 rupees from who? From Kosyam. It is easy to take name of Ram and Sam. Okay. So it is Sam's responsibility that he returns some of 100 rupees to Ram. So right now, Sam owes money, which is 100 rupees to Sam. That means Sam is obliged to pay 100 rupees to Ram. Okay. So what is Sam having? Okay. What is Sam having? Sam having the liability of 100 rupees. What is Ram having? Ram having assets of 100 rupees. Why? Because Ram is going to receive 100 rupees in upcoming future. Of course, remember when we were taking an example of asset, we said that account receivable will also come in assets. Okay. So what is liability? A liability is something which a person owes to some other person, to some other company, to some other business. Okay. Generally speaking, a liability is something that is owed to somebody else, that Sam owed 100 rupees to Ram. So 100 rupees will be a liability for Sam, but it has, because Sam has to give 100 rupees to Ram in future because he has taken 100 rupees from Ram. A liability can also mean a legal or regulatory risk or obligations. Okay, so assets is something which gives you value. They both are mostly treated in a monetary form, always remember. And liability is something which you owe to some other person or some other company. So this is what assets and liabilities are. Okay, in accounting terms, what we do, we always, whenever we start business, there is always assets equals to liability. Of it. Okay. Assets equals to liability. Okay, why am I saying that assets equals to liability? Suppose, let's take an example. Start with an example. We always take an example, okay? So let's start with an example. Suppose you have started business, say with rupees 5 lakhs. You have started business with rupees 5 lakhs, all right? So what is happening here? You are bringing cash for what? For company, for business, for company, whatever. So you have started business with 5 lakh rupees, and 5 lakh rupees will be what? Because you have brought cash in company, you have invested 5 lakh rupees in the company, and that's, of course, that's your company. So that will be treated as assets. That means company has 5 lakh rupees for itself. So now company has 5 lakh rupees. Remember when we talked about this last lecture, we've discussed about gap. In gap, there was a principle which is business entity concept, which tells us that business and owner of the business are two different entity. Okay, so let's back to the question. Business and the owner of the business are two different entity. We shall not take it as a single and one entity at all. So we will treat them definitely. So right now, what does business list say? The name of your company is ABC company. It will be easy for you to understand. ABC company. Okay, so this is an ABC company, and you have invested 5 lakh rupees in your company. So your company has now 5 lakh rupees for itself. So your company has assets of 5 lakh rupees. Now remember, because your company received 5 lakh rupees, it's liability, because your business obliges, because your business is not going to use 5 lakh rupees for itself, because it is not going to buy any goods, it is not going to consume anything. Of course, because business is an artificial person, not going to consume anything. All right. So that 5 lakh rupees which owner invested, and always remember, when owners brings money to the business, it will treated as equity. Okay, equity or owner's equity. When the owners invested money, it will treated as equity. When you borrowed money from bank or from the people, it will be treated as liability. It's the same thing. Okay, so that the moment business receive 5 lakh rupees, it become liable to pay it back to the owner of the business. So right now you can understand of the business. So you can easily understand that 5 lakh rupees business is receiving, it has to pay it back in the future to its owner. So business is now having assets of 5 lakh rupees as well as liability of 5 lakh rupees. Okay, because it has 5 lakh rupees with itself and it has to pay 5 lakh rupees in near future to who? To owner of the company. So that's how we say assets equals to liability. I hope you understand. Okay. Now, let's write down assets equals to liability. Remember, I've told you that if owner bringing money in business, it will be treated as equity. So we can say that liability plus equity equals to assets. Suppose 5 lakh rupees was invested by business and he took a loan of rupees 10 lakh from bank. So it will be treated as a liability. and the assets will increase by 5 lakh, 10 lakh rupees, it will be 15 lakh. Assets will be 15 lakh and the liability will be 15 lakh, from which 10 lakh is the liability and 5 lakh is equity, or we can call it owner's equity. All right. So assets equals to liability plus equity. Okay. So what is the point of doing business? We have already discussed it. Why are we doing business? Of course, we want to earn some profit. That's why we are doing business. So how are we going to earn some profit? If there is a profit, and always remember, profit is liability for the business. Okay, because if your business is earning profit, a business, ABC company, of course, name of company was ABC, has to give it to the who? It has to give it to the owner of the company, which is you, of course. In this case, you are the owner of the company. The profit which are occurring in the business, you are actually obliged to take it, and business is obliged to give it to you. So profit is in a liability. Okay. So that revenue, if there is revenue occurring, it will be treated as liability. Okay. So there is a liability, equity, profit, revenue. Isn't the case there? It is not necessary. Their business will always book profit. There could be some times when business fails, some will face some losses, that you can see in this pandemic. There are so many companies who are actually facing losses. So what will we do with the losses? Remember in the last lecture, we, of course, in this lecture itself, when we were discussing traditional approach, we said we debit all the expenses and losses. So this, when the loss will occur, we will deduct it, because there is a loss and liability is reducing by with the loss. So because there is no profit, so there is no liability of business to pay back to its owner. So we will minus the loss. Okay. And to earn revenue, we must spend some money. So expense, as we say, revenue is treated as liability. So expense, we will minus expenses, because if owner is going to spend, if it has 15 lakh rupees, say example, if it has 15 lakh rupees with it, and around withdrawn money is ABC, you have withdrawn some money to purchase car. Yeah, you purchase car for business. So what is it? 5 lakh rupees. It is what? Expense. So because it was having 15 lakh rupees, now you spend 5 lakh rupees. Now you are left with 10 lakh rupees. So your assets will decrease by 5 lakh rupees, as well as your liability is. Okay, because you have spent 5 lakh rupees on purchasing a car. Of course, it will, of course, increase the asset with the 5 lakh rupees, because the car is an asset also. The car is an asset. So we will not discuss it in the deep. For now, you should understand assets. You can please remember this formula. Assets equals to liability and plus equity, or it could also call owner's equity. Equity on owner's equity plus profit plus revenue minus loss minus expenses, minus losses or minus expenses. Okay. So what is the nature of assets? Remember what we were saying, what comes in will be what? Debited. What goes out will be what? Credited. All right. So the basic nature of asset is debit. Yeah, you can say balance of assets will be treated as debit. Let me. We'll take time, of course. We write down from the very beginning. Okay. Assets equals to liability plus capital plus profit plus revenue minus expenses minus losses. All right. So what is the basic of assets? What is the base of assets? It is debit. Okay. Whenever assets increase, we debit it. All right. Whenever assets increase, we debit it. So what will be the balance of liability? What will be the nature of liability? Of course, it is opposite of assets. So debit and credit are opposite of each other. So liability will be treated as a credit balance. Liability has credit balance. So whenever liability increases, we will credit it. Of course, the capital is also liability. So whenever the capital increases, we will credit it. When the profit increases, of course, we are doing all the in the last previous lecture, on the same lecture, of course, in the previous slides, profit we were crediting. So whenever there is a profit, we will credit it. When there is a revenue, we will credit it. All right, you can see liability will be credited, capital credited, profit credited, revenue credited. Expense, on the other hand, as a mathematical formula, you can take it from here to there, then it will become positive. And what is the balance of assets? It is debit balance. So in the same way, expense will also has debit balance. So whenever expense increase, we will debit it. Whenever the loss occur, we will what? Debit it. Okay? In the same way, if the assets is increasing, we will debit it. If the asset is decreasing, we will credit it. The same way, if the liability is increasing, we will credit it. Increasing, we will credit it. If it's decreasing, we will debit it. If the capital is increasing, we will credit it. If the capital is decreasing, we will debit it. Profit is increasing, we will credit it. Profit is decreasing, we will debit it. Revenue is increasing, we will credit it. Revenue is decreasing, we will debit it. All right. In the same way, expense is increasing, we will debit it. Expense is decreasing, we will credit it. Loss is increasing, we will debit it. Loss is decreasing, we will credit it. All right. So this is your what? Modern approach. Let's go with the picture. See, you can easily say now, so you can better understand what was I saying. Modern rules of accounting, we have actually classified into 5 groups. One is capital, assets, liability, expense, and income. Okay. So whenever capital increase, you can see in the picture, we will debit it because the balance of capital is debit. So when capital increase, we will debit it. When the capital decrease, we will credit it. Assets has, on the other hand, what? Debit balance. So whenever assets increase, we will debit it. Whenever assets decrease, we will credit it. Liability has credit balance. When the liability increase, we will credit it. When the liability decrease, we will debit it. Expense has what? Cost. Debit balance, whenever expense or losses, both, okay? Whenever expense losses increase, we will debit it. And whenever it decrease, we will credit it. On the other hand, income and profit. Whenever income increase, we will credit it. Whenever income or losses decrease, they will debit it. So this is your modern rules of accounting. Okay. You can say capital is the rule is applicable to the all owners transactions. Whenever any money is brought in by owner, it will treated as a what? Capital or earnest equity. Okay. The rules applicable to all assets of the business. And we have taken example of the business. Assets which is cash, which are cash, land, building, plant, machinery, furniture, picture, trade, amounts, and etc. Assets, okay, which has debit balance. Always remember, liability, bank loan, mortgage loan, creditors, short-term loan,
etc. It has what? Credit balance, expense. It has what? Debit balance, income. It has what? Credit balance. I hope this is your rules of accounting. Okay. So this is it for today's lecture. Thank you all. Take care. God bless you all.